Welcome back to Doc's Hot Shop and Forge. So today we have about 15, maybe 16 centimeters of wrought iron axle. It is 1 inch by 1 inch or 25 by 25. So it's about 6 inches long, maybe 6 1/4. And we have a scrap of old spring steel, which I will chop a piece out of. And what we're going to make is a small Viking travel anvil. These were used for repairs whilst the Vikings were out on trading missions or raidings. And it was just a handy way to repair things, make arrowheads and that sort of thing. So, that's what we're going to make. Let's get this hot. Let's have some fun. Rectangular face with a pronounced heel, so we can drive a little square hole through for nail making. And that way this would have been a travelling sort of shipwright's anvil. Make nails, straighten things, just generally do a little bit of work whilst on the boat. I want to concentrate more mass up near the what's going to be the working face. Thank you. little divot out. Out towards 50. Awkward.
on the very first, very most delicate of welding heats, where I just had it sitting on top of each other, and the weight of the anvil squeezed out the flux. I've got just enough contact to hold it together, so I could bring it to the anvil and give it a few taps before going back in. tricky bit because I don't have much room to play with. Now, I had thought to quench this in water, but due to the micro-cracking that I can see in it, being welded to wrought iron, it should actually survive pretty well in use, but I had thought to quench it in water, but given those cracks, I'm going to quench it in oil and accept the slightly lower hardness that's going to result. So, let's get this hot and get it quenched. Like though.
brings us to the end of that. Nice, quick, relatively speaking, little anvil project. I do have still a couple of burrs in here that I really need to get out. It's grabbing the nails if I don't get the taper just right. But otherwise, this works really well. I'm surprised I managed to get it out of the stump. But wood is very, very dry. But still, draws well. And works nicely. This one will go into my collection, largely because the faceplate has got some micro-cracking from being recycled spring steel. I'll put a picture up of that at the end, which is really disappointing. But it is what it is, and it's the risk you take with recycled materials. The nails, well, the height and the angle made getting the heads right very, very difficult. But they're nails, and they'll work. So that's what I'm going to leave off. If you've enjoyed this video, hit the thumbs up. Feel free to share on social media. And if you haven't already subscribed, I'd love it if you hit that subscribe button. When you do, don't forget, ring the notification bell. So get out to your shop. Have some fun. Do something just off the wall a bit. But whatever you do, stay safe, and I'll catch you for the next one.